And so as the chief engineer, you need to use your experience and your judgment, and you need to interact with your team in a way that you can identify the areas on the project where additional testing or richer testing or honestly more expensive testing can yield the maximum benefit to the project. There was a situation on COTS. I would say it was about 2 years, maybe 2.5 years before we flew the mission. We had a small subset of our engineering team approached me and said, "Jim, we should do this spacecraft in the loop testing. This is a form of testing that was not in our plan. It was not in our budget." And so this spacecraft in the loop testing, essentially what you do is you take the Cygnus service module and you wrap a simulator around it so that the service module sees data that lets its software and system functionality believe that it is in space. We actually take the gyro data and we put biases back into the system to make it believe it's in space. And we do that with all of the inputs into Cygnus. And it proceeded to clutter up the operation and drive the integration team nuts because it didn't work perfectly the first time around. But it was a form of testing that I would call, it was a high order test. It included the most things that were going to fly. And when that testing initially wasn't going well, initially we were learning how to make the test work. We were learning how the equipment functioned. We were learning where our EGSE wasn't perfect. And we knocked all those things down. And then the test still wouldn't fly. Cygnus still wouldn't climb the R-bar. Cygnus would still have trouble running that test. This test is the one test that is telling us that our software is not ready. It is telling us that there's something still not right in the software. And you know, after a lot of struggle and perseverance, we got that test working smoothly. And in the process of going through that struggle, we actually identified two or three items that were potentially mission-ending deficiencies in the software, and in particular how the software worked with the idiosyncrasies that were coming out of the sensors and devices in the Cygnus. And so that test paid for itself 100 times, yet it wasn't in the budget, and parts of our team were advocating not to do it. So, you know, to conclude, as a chief engineer, you have to find those tests and do them. Because those are the hard ones, and those are the ones that pay off the most. And they're not easy, and you're going to struggle, but it'll pay off in the end.